born in the hard business world, a doer. Sana Bagirsch is one of the rare species who is perfectly at home in both worlds. Adjunct professor, university advisor, bureau chief of the Gulf, but then she performs as well as a CEO of a leading UA marketing company, as a board member of the Tempo magazine, and as a successful innovation advisor.
Sana is a real jack of all trades. She is not only talking about it, she was herself powerful enough to do it. With the characteristic topic, Unlock the Power in You, please welcome Sana Bagirsch.
Hi everyone. It's been amazing listening to these ladies and very invigorating going through the breathing exercises because I do a lot of things. And I'm learning to try to focus and slow down and realign my life. So I try to go through a period of realignment all the time. So what do I do? Right now I'm an innovation advisor for Abu Dhabi Municipality. And trying to position the municipality as the catalyst for the digital transformation in Abu Dhabi City. So what we're doing is a massive exercise of bringing government entities together, bringing the corporates, bringing the enablers as well, and establishing a conversation that will help move Abu Dhabi to next gen Abu Dhabi. So this is currently what I do. I run a platform called Tamakkan, which is basically monthly seminars that focus on three pillars. One is innovation, one is entrepreneurship, and one is on leadership. The other thing that I do is we have a competition called the Smoothies. And it's a collaboration with Vox Cinemas, the U.S. Embassy, and a few other entities as well. And inshallah, in 2 weeks, we will have a press conference to announce the new season of the Smoothies. And 2016, I almost died. And this is when I was close to a thyroid storm, and this was at Amcham. I don't remember if you remember 2016. They were announcing the new board of Amcham, and I was standing there and I delivered a speech and I could barely speak. And I think at that point I realized that maybe it was my body telling me that I need to rethink my life. So after that, I had been on the board of Amcham for 4 years, and that was then Dr. Musa. When I went to the president, I told him I'm not running again. I need to revise, I need to realign, and I need to find out what I want to do with my time. I reorganized the agency. I run a marketing company at 2454. I reorganized it. As you know, if you're in the marketing business, there's been a huge disruption in marketing. And so I try to just, you know, move the building blocks, focus on some of the things. A lot of tenders came to me and I said, I learned to say no. And that was difficult. A lot of things, you know, customers would come back. And what I would do is measure it. And I'd say, this customer here, this is the value that they bring to me commercially. This is the value they bring to me in terms of happiness and contentment. And this is the angst that they bring to me. So what I started to do was to evaluate everything, not just based on commercial or even my passion, but also the amount of angst or irritation it brought to me. And so I started something, and I don't know if this is going to work for you guys, but I'll tell you my new trick. My son calls it Sana 2.0. And this is to basically look at all of the little things in my life that are speed bumps. Right? And so sometimes you have speed bumps in your life that you are not aware is there. And I'll give you a couple of examples of that. I come from a family. How many Germans in this room? I don't want to offend any Germans. Good. Okay. So, a Swiss. Okay. I apologize in advance. So I come from a family that loves BMWs, right? So my father had a BMW, my brothers, five brothers, I'm an only girl, everybody had a BMW in my family. And so, 2 months ago, I thought to myself, I'm going through all of this speed bump realignment thing, and I thought, what are the things that give me trouble? One of them was my BMW, really. Because, number one, I was paying so much to get it repaired. It was too advanced that even the repair guys didn't know how to fix it. So my dials were always, you know, flickering. And for me, that just made me anxious because I didn't know whether it was going to stop at any point. So I ditched my BMW. And I called my brothers and I told them I bought a new car. Guess what I bought? Which brand? Oh my gosh, you guys are good. I bought a Toyota Yaris. My brothers were horrified. They said, you're a CEO, you're innovation advisor for the municipality, you're a speaker, you're gonna go in a Yaris? I told them, damn right I am. And so normally, the thing with these little things, the Gucci bag, the BMW, and all that, is they open the doors. So I tested it on Thursday. I had a meeting with Nathan Habsi, the CEO of Emirates Foundation. So usually I go zipping with my BMW, they open the door for me. So I zipped in on Thursday, and they said, the parking lot is over there. And I looked at them and I said, I have a meeting with Nathan Habsi, she's waiting for me, and I'm from the municipality. They said, oh, but ma'am, yeah, we understand, but the parking is there. So the minute the door opens for the guy in front of me, I quickly slip in. I follow him. And then I go in and the security guard comes running to me and he says, what are you doing here? You have to go there. And I took out my Belediye card and I said, I'm from the municipality. So that was my card at that point. But the whole issue here is it's for me already, I feel like I can go to places faster. I don't have to worry about my gas tank. I don't have to worry about my dials. Everything is just so easy. So the second phase of the 2.0 was to look at my day. What are the speed bumps that I keep doing every time that just, first of all, annoy me and take that valuable time that I could be using elsewhere? My phone. My son, Ayman, he looked at it and he said, Mom, this cannot be a 2.0 phone there. He said, you have too many folders. For you to find the thing to call, you have to go through like four panels. This is just not right. So he realigned the phone for me. So my message here to you is look at all of these small things, because sometimes it's the smallest things that are very, very repetitive that will take your time. I'll give you a more corporate example. So I worked, there's a company called King Casey. I don't know if you guys have heard of King Casey. They're, one of the top communication marketing companies out of the States. And so I authored a couple of papers with them. And one of their clients was McDonald's. And the guy from King Casey told me, you know how time is so valuable? So McDonald's go to him, to King Casey, and they say, we want you to look at the menu, the drive-thru menu. How can you save all the time? And he said, we studied, and so what they do is they do this customer experience exercise where they track how when you go into like a store and go to buy something, they look at every eye movement and they track every step that you take to see how they can optimize it. Every step, every second was time and money. So when McDonald's go to King Casey, one of the founders in Stanley, he said, they came to us and they said, how can you re-engineer the drive-thru menu? So he says, all we did was we looked at it, we made this picture smaller, we moved this to this, and we changed the font. It was something as simple as that. It was just minor tweaks. And he showed me the before, and he showed me the after. he had to tell me what those changes were. So McDonald's paid King Casey $1 million to do that. Right? $1 million to do that. And I thought, wow, what a good job you have over there, you know? And he said, yeah, but do you know how much time and money it saved McDonald's? It was over $60 million a year. So here, some things, my message here basically is, sometimes in life, it could be a simple thing. Maybe it's the fact that you don't have a charger for your phone. By the way, this is my story. Now I have chargers for my phone in every room in the house. You know, it might be something as simple as that. It could be where you keep your keys. It could be where you have your notepad. It could be your purse. You should see my purse now. It's very small, it's very aligned. Because normally I take like 5 minutes to find something in my big purse. So just simplify. When I go to my wardrobe, I can take out a pair of pants, and I can take a top, and usually, 70% of the time, they work. And I just simplified the colors, you know, just so things work faster. Am I lazy? Yes. Is this the journey for all of you? I don't know. But my basic advice to you is, try to see if there are any speed bumps in your life that are slowing you down, because these little speed bumps could have an effect not just on your productivity, but also on your, you know, your psychological state as well. You know, your level of enthusiasm for things. And the speed bump could be something, it could be someone, it could be something that you always put in the back of your mind because you just don't want to deal with it. It could be as simple as that. So this is my advice to you. Thank you very much, everyone.